that. Hopefully that's the...
Dropped one out of the head box. That's an 861. Okay. So really got to get this faster. Really needs to be under five, I think, for that fast coin. So I really want that. One good one dropped on here. These four are like whatever, but 861. So I got to do that way faster. So yeah, we'll try it again. Really need to get this under five. Let's see if I set it up right. Hopefully that's good. Oh shoot, I need more ammo. Whew. All right, here we go. All right, that was a 447. So that's gonna do it for the time. The first time I've run it under four or under 5 seconds. I do have a mic over here, so need to clean that up. And that one's a Charlie, but that one's pretty close. And then I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I did drop one down here, but yeah, that's the closest I've been so far. 447, coming for that fast coin. A lot of people these days are using shot timers to practice at the range, and we are huge proponents of that. If you've seen any of what we've done in the past, you guys know we've got to be practicing with shot timers, and we've got to be using things like hit factor scoring to track progress. We're huge on tracking your progress and getting measurable results or metrics to know exactly where you are and what exactly you need to work on. Something we're seeing a lot right now, though, is people using shot timers, and that's awesome, but they're using them, I would say, not to their full potential. What do we mean by full potential? Well, there's a lot of information inside the shot timer that we can gather, and it's not just the overall time. So in the intro we just filmed, you guys saw us kind of being a little facetious, shooting pretty poorly, but honestly, that was exactly where I was a few years ago. I was going to the range, I was setting goals for myself, I was trying to just meet par times, but I wasn't doing a good job of diving into the timer, checking out what is the timer actually telling me about my performance and how can I improve that performance. All right, so what we want to do today is we want to actually dive into that exact drill, the fast drill, and show you guys how you can kind of break down everything the timer is telling you, where we can identify areas to improve on, and what we're doing good already. Hopefully then, that would give us a roadmap to go dry fire those skills, right? Isolate some of those skills into their kind of component skills, and then put it all back together and actually accomplish something that we set out to do. So we're gonna dive into that, and this is our breakdown on the fast drill, utilizing a shot timer the right way.
We just want to thank the sponsor of this channel, Blue Alpha. We've been running Blue Alpha belts pretty much ever since the beginning. Some of our very first EDC belts and duty belts were Blue Alpha, and they've seen some very hard use, and they've been our favorite belts for a long, long time. So we could not be more stoked to have them as a sponsor of the channel. If you guys are looking for awesome belts and a lot of other nylon products made here in the USA, go ahead and check out BlueAlphaBelts.com. If you're looking to support the channel, there's gonna be a link in the description below that you guys can use to support us and get some awesome belts from an awesome company. So kind of a win-win. So big thanks to Blue Alpha. Back to the video.
All right, so we're gonna just jump right into it with some math, okay? So I'm gonna be throwing a lot of numbers at you guys, but bear with us, and I'll try to make it pretty simple. So the last run you guys saw in the intro where I finally got that run under 5 seconds, 447, I think it was. Yeah, so let's take a look. So on my AMG lab timer, I can actually look back at all these splits for a couple different runs. So what I've got is I'm showing a 2.21 draw at 7 yards to like a 3x5 card, okay? A 6-5 split, We had a 4.58 reload, so that's shot to shot, and then we had a 0.27 split, a 0.48 split, a 0.42, and then, yeah, that was it, right? So 2.7, 4.8, 4.2, that was that trigger freeze you might have heard. Trigger freeze, right? So yeah, total time on that was a 4.47. And you know, I was acting like I was really excited for sub five. I remember when I did my first sub five run on this clean, I was really excited. And a lot of times we try to go fast, figure out what that feels like, what that looks like, and then try to figure out how we get those hits at that speed. So that's really not a bad way to practice. But what we're gonna do is break it down for you guys and make it super attainable. So the goal is to do it under 5 seconds. So 4.99 or better, okay? And so the way we have this broken down, essentially what you need is you're gonna need a 1.5 second draw, okay? That's to that 3x5 card. Let's say you get a 0.5 split for that second shot, all right? Our reload, if we give ourselves 2 seconds, all right, now we've used 4 seconds of that time. We have 1 second left to do our last 3 shots. And remember, we only have 3 shots left to calculate because that reload is shot to shot. So draw to first shot, second split, reload to the next shot. Okay, we're at 4 seconds. And then we've got 1 second left to spare. So we divide that by three, you know, 0.3, 0.33. Let's just say 0.3 for easy math. That'll put us at a 4.9. And so we'll easily be right in there for that, you know, sub five run, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna just jump into it and just go in that order, draw, splits on the head box, we'll do the reloads, we'll isolate that, and then those last 3 splits, we'll figure out how we need to shoot those at about 0.3 or a third of a second, okay? So let's get right into it with the draw. So take a look at the target here at first, right? We've got a 3x5 like dotted line here, so that's a 3x5 card in size. And then we've got an A zone down here, okay? So it's supposed to be an 8-inch circle, I think, but we're just gonna use a USPSA A zone. And it's pretty similar. It might be a little bit more forgiving, but we'll roll with it. So, yeah, so let's just get right into it. So first thing is the draw. So we've gotta hit a 1.5 second draw for shot, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and put a fresh mag in here. 1.5 first shot. So I honestly don't know what my draw time to this head box is right now, so we'll figure it out, but I'm gonna try to nail a 1.5. Good on that, here we go. One shot to the head box, stand by. All right, so 1.58, right? Not really pushing the speed really at all. I actually landed it in the USPSA A zone credit card, but well within the 3x5. Okay, so 1.58, that's actually about where I wanna be for the fast drill, okay? But it is like 0.08 of a second over. So let's try to get that more around that 1.5 second mark and or maybe even a little faster. The thing is, every time we try to accomplish one of these goals, right? If I set a 1.5 goal for myself, right? If I do better than that, I'm actually gonna be able to use that time somewhere else, right? But maybe the draw is the thing that I'm the worst at, and so I need a little bit more time there, and I'll shave off some time somewhere else. Maybe my reloads are really good. So 1.58, let's try it one more time, or a couple more times here, and see if we could do any better. Stand by. All right, so 1.52, again, right there in that A box. Feeling really good about the hits. I'm seeing my dot settle nice and still in the center of that. Let's push the speed a little bit and see if we can come up with something a little bit better. Here we go. All right, there we go, dead center. That was a 1.37. Okay, so 1.37. So I feel pretty good about that. A 1.37 is gonna give me a little bit of extra time for some of that other stuff. So we're good there. So next thing is gonna be that second split. That second split, we've gotta be able to do that at 0.5 or better. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually just gonna start with the gun out. I'm just gonna plug that head box twice and see kind of what a 0.5 split looks like, okay? So doesn't really matter that the when the timer goes off, we'll let it just kind of beep here, and then we're just gonna pop and pop and see if we can, you know, just feel that half second split. Here we go. All right, so that split was a 0.75. So too slow, right? Too slow. All right, so let's try it again. All right, and that was it. So that was a 0.45 split. Okay, 0.45. Let's do that one more time and see if we can repeat that. Okay, that was a little bit faster, 0.41. Super happy with that, right? So I'm beating my kind of goal by about a tenth, which is great. If I can beat all my goals by a tenth, I'm gonna be well within that five and have a lot of kind of breathing room in case I mess something up when I actually go to do it live. 0.41, super happy with that. All right, so what's next? We did the draw, we did the split time, okay? Now let's do the reload. So the reload is gonna be measured shot to shot. So it's really that second shot we just plugged in the head box, it's reloading, and then down into that center A zone, okay? So time for this, we said about 2 seconds. 2 seconds is actually pretty quick for an appendix reload, right? I've seen some people maybe break this drill down into like a 2.5, and then maybe you get like 0.2 splits at the end. We'll figure it out though. 2 second reload, I think we can do it. For this one, we'll set it up for slide lock because I believe that's what you're supposed to do for the drill. All right, here we go. This will go to slide lock. We'll practice this, one in the head, reload, one to the body, and I'm just gonna start aimed in on the head. Here we go. All right, again, not really pushing the speed at all. That was a 2.63, all right? So I know I can cut out a lot of fat there, so we'll set this up again. Do a little bit of a tack mag here and start the timer over. All right, missed the magwell a little bit, but we're doing better. That's a 2.47, all right, 2.47.
Make 101s great again.
Right. All right, so where can I trim the fat, okay? I already know that my hands are moving really slow, so as soon as that shot breaks and I see my dot lift, I can already be taking that left hand off the gun and going for that new mag, okay? Everything can be really fast until I'm actually inserting the mag into the mag well, okay? So lining that up and getting it aligned just right is the hardest part about it. All right, here we go. Try again. All right, there we go. So 1.85, all right, 1.85. That second shot dropped a little bit lower than the middle of the A zone, which I'm fine with, right? Giving myself the whole A zone for this, but that is right where we need to be. So let's make sure we can do it consistently. One more time, and then we'll move on. All right, I know that was sub two, and yep, that was a 1.8. All right, so not really wasting any time. Nailing those reloads, good. The first hit was obviously gonna be good. I was aimed in on target, but my second hit was also good in that upper half of the A zone, so I'm happy with that. All right, so that is the, that's the first three steps. Draw, second split, reloading. We're reloading under 2 seconds, which is great. Now it's up to kind of figure out those last three splits. So I'm just gonna start aimed in on the target, okay? I'm gonna give myself the timer again, and then we're just going to see what do like third second splits look like, 0.3. We'll try this a couple different times. I'm actually gonna switch that to full mag here. All right, hit that timer, and we'll just try three shots right in that 80. All right. Super easy. Let's see. That was a 5.8, 5.9. 5.8 and 5.9. So need to be a little quicker than that. I'll actually do four so we can read three splits. Let's cut that time in about half. There we go. All All right, still keeping a nice tight group down there in the target. And let's see, we got a 3-4, a 3-2, and a 3-0. So actually, that's right at that target time. Remember, I saved a little time on the draw, saved a little time on the reload. So those splits right there would get me in, okay? I'm gonna try one more time. Let's see if we can drop it just under 0.3, just to give me a little bit more breathing room and make me feel a little bit better about myself, and then we'll put it all together. Here we go. Four splits. All right, there we go. So, checking out the timer. That was a 2-2, a 1-9, a 1-9. All right, so that's definitely gonna get me right in there. I'm actually saving up about a tenth of a second on that goal time, okay? So for me, my current level of skill, saving a tenth of a second on each one of these is probably about right, okay, for kind of on-demand, clean performance. So let's put it all together now. I'm gonna pace it up, and we will shoot it for real. Internet accountability, all of my rounds on the target, right? For the most part, keeping them up here, I'm giving myself the whole A zone, but honestly, I think I can shoot it clean in the upper half of the A zone, and then, of course, all of this rounds in the head box as well. So, this is something that is overlooked a lot. I think people set goals for themselves, and then they don't really know how to accomplish those goals. And people will say, oh man, I just gotta get more reps, do more reps. That's not always the case, right? Purposeful reps over anything else is always gonna be better than just hammering something out and expecting it to come, right? I've heard somebody say, like, you know, just start out slow and carefully and the speed will come, right? Well, not really. You've got to figure out where you need to trim the fat, and you need to actually go fast and go at those speeds to figure out what does it feel like to go fast, and then it's up to you to kind of put it all together. So all of these skills, I'm gonna say it again, all of these skills should be practiced in dry fire. I would not spend a lot of my ammo at the live fire range doing this drill. I would practice this in dry fire and then go validate those skills on the range. But you guys are here to see us shoot, so that's what we're gonna do. All right, set this up. One in the chamber, and a full mag in the reload. Oh, actually, I need two in there. Yeah, there we go. Math is hard, guys.
Never math in public.
Correct. Especially if you're not a math Asian. I'm not a math Asian, I'm a violent Asian. All right, here we go. We're gonna put it all together. Two shots, slide lock reload, and then four shots in the A zone. Let's see what we can do. All right, pushed one high. So, first shot here, second shot here. Last four in the A zone. That was right at a 470. So hitting my target time just perfectly, fumbled my reload, and had a bad shot. But let's look at the times, right? What were we doing before for our first shot drop? Our goal was a 1.5. I think I was pulling out about a 1.3 or 1.4, and that was a 1.34 first shot, okay? Right on target. The split time up there was a 0.39, so just about a 0.4. Again, 1/10 under that 0.5, which is exactly what I needed. Of course, I messed up, but that target time is right there. 2:42 reload. You guys saw me fumble that reload a little bit. So here's where buying back a little time on the draw and the splits are helpful for me. 2:42 reload, 0.42 over my target time, but it still doesn't matter too much because those last three shots, let's see, we did a 2-1, a 1-7, and a 1-7. So really kind of blazed those last four splits down. And to be honest, I was feeling like I needed to make up a little bit of time, and so I did. But I know I don't have to shoot that fast. So we're gonna pace this up, we're gonna do it again, and not suck so bad. All right, so set this back up again. One in the pipe, one in the mag, fresh mag in the holster. All right, here we go. All right, that's gonna do it for the first clean sub-5 run, okay? 479. Nothing there looks super rushed. I didn't try to make up any time. Just try to be as efficient as possible. So I've got two shots right next to each other right here in the 3x5 card. That's perfect. And then four shots here. I don't know if it came through on camera, but there was a little bit of what my buddy Chris would call visual patience going on, right? Where I saw my dot track a little bit too far left. You guys can see three of these shots were left. Got a little uncomfortable about that and actually allowed myself to correct that over to the center of the A zone. So really happy with that, 479, and that is the way you do it. So let's check out the times. Are my times tracking? So 139 draw, which is great. Saving a 10th off that goal time. 4-7 split, right on track, saving a little bit of time there. 210 reload, so it gave back a little bit of time from that goal of 2 seconds. Truth be told, a little bit rusty on the reloads these days, but 210, okay? And then I had a 3-2, a 2-7, and a 2-4. All right, so we are coming in just under all of those goal times and a total time of 4-7-9. I mean, come on, that math works out, okay? So. That's pretty much it, guys. That's how I would break something down like this. Obviously, it's gonna take you longer. Like, if you're really at an 860 for the fast drill, man, it's gonna probably take some time, a few weeks, months, or something like that to get down to the point where you're doing it sub five. But that's pretty much the process that I would follow, and I think the results speak for themselves. All right, now that we've established a baseline of essentially what I can do on a target like this at 7 yards, we're gonna shoot another drill that's incorporating two targets, all the same metrics that applied before because I'm shooting it from the same distance, but this time we're gonna add in some target transitions, okay? And so we're not gonna break it down in as much detail, but I'm gonna read off the splits on the timer, and now hopefully you guys have kind of a basis of, okay, I know what he's talking about now. So this drill is called the box drill, okay? We got this drill from Amy Abbott, Amy556 on Instagram. Make sure you go follow her. But she, a while back, put up a website full of drills and things, and this is one of them. And honestly, I think maybe back 3 years ago or something like that, Justin and I were both shooting this drill and posting it on Instagram. If you scroll far enough back in our Instagrams, you can probably find it. Essentially what it is, well, you can actually shoot this drill a lot of different ways, but the way we're gonna do it is we're gonna shoot target one in the A box, then target two in the A box, then we'll transition up to the head of target two, and then the head box of target one. Go for alphas in this, right? In that head box, we were shooting that credit card, and that's kind of where we were getting our baseline speed. I'm gonna try to plug alphas. If I get a close Charlie in there, it'll be all right. We could score this hit factor. We're not going to right now, just to save a little bit of time. Just kind of give you guys an idea of the time metrics, and we'll pull that off from the timer. So the thing that this drill is going to do differently than the fast drill is what this adds in is target transitions, okay? That's shooting one target, transitioning over, and then shooting another target, okay? And we have several target transitions in here. I'm going to shoot it first the way that I see most people shoot this drill for the first time, and we're going to analyze the timer and just figure out, is there any place that I can shave down time and see what the timer tells us. All right, here we go. All right, draw, fire two to the body, two to the body, two to the head, two to the head. Here we go, stand by. All right, that was a 5.3. Okay, so on first glance, I don't know what you thought of that, right? But I was splitting the gun pretty fast. If you look at the targets, I have pretty good hits. So I have two alpha here, alpha Charlie here, two alpha here, alpha Charlie here. So honestly, that's pretty good. That's about the hits that I wanted. If we look at the timer and let's read off some of these splits, let's just kind of see what we're looking at. So first of all, we had a 150 draw. So if we remember back to shooting the fast drill, I was looking for a 150 draw in the credit card, okay? So that tells me that a 150 draw to the A zone is way too slow. I have way more kind of forgiveness here, okay? That's a great point we're already taking away. Had a 0.22 split right here in the A zone. That checks out from the fast drill. I was happy with that, all right? And I had a 9-8 transition. So the time it took me to shoot the second shot here to the first shot here took me 0.98 seconds, all right? Almost a full second. From there, we had a 0.22 split here, so identical splits, checks out. from here to here, I had a 0.82 transition. I had a 0.30 split in the head. That checks out. All right, and then a 0.88 transition over to this head, okay? And then a 0.38 split up here in this head box, surf total time of 5:30. So based off of all of that, I can already tell I need to shave time off the draw, okay? Happy with the splits here, happy with the splits here. The splits here were pretty quick. I'm okay with it. I think I could dial it back just a touch and maybe get more alphas. But really what I'm seeing is I'm seeing these very large numbers, 0.98 and 0.88, between targets. So between these two A zones, between this A zone and this head box, and between this head box and the first head box. And so let's figure out what I can do to actually decrease those times and contribute to an overall faster time, which is what we're after. A 5:30, I want to do that much faster than that, but I think I can really trim some fat off of those transitions. So let's shoot this again and see if I can kind of make those transitions a little quicker. We'll do another video where we actually break down target transitions and how to get better at them. But for now, just understand that as soon as the second shot on that target that you're shooting breaks, or your last shot breaks, your eyes need to quickly get to the next target, and you're gonna move the gun and just kind of follow your eyes with the gun. So anywhere the eyes go, the dot goes. Anywhere the dot is, the bullets go. So I need to just be on top of that and essentially be more efficient with my vision. All right, so we'll shoot this again, go for the same hits, just be a little bit more efficient with our vision. Here we go, stand by. All right, that was a 343. All right, so before we even look at the targets, I'm looking at a 122 draw to first shot. Big improvement there. I have a 0.20 split, so about the same split. And instead of a 9.8 transition, this time I have a 0.33 transition. So we're saving about 0.7 seconds or a little bit less than that on the transition. 19 split, and then a 32 transition to the head, a 35 split, a 43 transition to the next head, and a 39 split. So the splits didn't really change much, but my transitions did, and my draw to first shot was much better. So let's check out the targets. So over here, two new shots in the A zone, okay? So two A zone hits there. I got two new A zone hits here. This one I dropped a little bit low, but it's still in the head box, so that's gonna be okay. So that's an alpha line break there and a Charlie here. And then transitioned over, and it was, I think I had Charlie there. So it was another alpha and then a Charlie right there below. So same at pretty much exact same hits, I think. So two alpha, alpha Charlie, and a total time of 343. So before I did a 530 down to a 343. So we're already saving almost 2 seconds there, which is really, really great for a drill like this, only 8 shots, okay? So hopefully you guys can see, as I break down those split times and I'm looking at, hey, where can I shave some fat? I immediately identified, hey, those transitions look like they're taking a really long time. If I work on decreasing that transition split, what is that gonna do for me? And as you can see, much, much better, okay? So it doesn't mean that I just have to shoot faster or just do more reps at the thing. It means I'm going to identify where in the drill I'm actually being inefficient, and the rest is history, okay? So laying down a 343, let's shoot it one more time just for fun, see how fast we can go, and yeah, have a little bit of fun with it. Okay, that was a little wild and crazy. So that was a 250 overall time, definitely Mike the last shot in the head box. We'll take a look at the hits first and then we'll break it down. So. Charlie Delta, Alpha Charlie, Alpha, actually two Alpha there, and then over here I had a Charlie and a Mike. All right, so absolutely getting crazy with it, but I had to do that because I hate shooting slow. All right, so 109 draw, okay, that's pretty good for me. A 16 split, a 16 transition, all right, and a 17 split. I had a 19 transition to the head, a 21 split, a 26 transition to the head, and a 26 split. So actually my slowest split was actually a mic, which is actually very disappointing. But guys, that is pretty much it. I'm gonna leave it at that. Gotta have a little bit of fun on the range. If you're not having fun on the range, like, you might as well just pack it up and go home. But what I want you to leave you guys with is, you've gotta use your shot timer to its full potential. So if you're working towards any goal of any sort and you're using a shot timer to measure your progress, don't neglect diving into the settings on your shot timer and reading off those individual split times and getting valuable information that you can use to actually get better. Okay, so my last run, a 2.5 on an 8-shot drill, pretty crazy. But honestly, I know for myself, and we'll probably do this as soon as the video is over, actually try to shoot up 2.5, but get all my hits, right? And that tells me that I am capable of certain things. And the only way I would know that in such great detail is diving into that shot timer and actually getting information and plugging it all together, okay? So guys, if you have any questions about how to use your shot timer, how to build training plans, how to work on this type of stuff at dry fire, any of that type of stuff, be sure to hit us up in the comments and we will get back to you. We really appreciate you guys subscribing. If this content is helpful for you, we appreciate you guys sharing that as well. Until then, keep practicing your shooting, and we'll see you on the range.